happiness, success. These are all things that are attainable by all of us. But if we live intentionally and consciously on a path towards what we think are happiness and success. And that's the quandary I found myself in recently, was rethinking what success and happiness actually meant. In fact, I had the wrong ideas of what those were supposed to be, and I was practicing those ideas based on what had been passed down to me from previous generation and the generation before that. We live in interesting times, I think, as the wise man once said. Maybe it should have been the wise woman. What does it mean to be alive today? What does happiness and success look like? Now, there's a saying that life is what happens when you look up from your smartphone, or life is what happens around you when you're too busy looking at your social networks and checking your feeds or scrolling or looking at how many likes or friends you got. That's a reality of life. You can't shut it off. You can't just put it down. But there are things that we can do and things that we can learn, and definitely things that we can unlearn to live a better life, to live a happier life, to live a more successful life when we rethink what success means. What does happiness even mean? What's your purpose? When you go to make a decision between right and wrong, between what you know and what you don't know, what is that reference guide? I found myself constantly losing touch with everything that I held sacred. All of my conventions, all of my beliefs were suddenly being challenged by some opinion online or by someone else who had more followers or someone else who had more influence. I started questioning myself. I did a research project as a digital anthropologist for a major beauty brand. It took me a whole year where I interviewed women between the ages of 6 and 61 to understand the impact of technology and social networks like Instagram and Snapchat and Facebook, apps like Facetune, and what it had done to their self-esteem and what it had done to their own definition of self-beauty. Our relationship with all of these things is affecting our self-esteem. It's affecting our idea of success and our idea of happiness. And whether we're downgrading those things or we're looking elsewhere or we're just too distracted or busy with everything that's going on, or we're just trying to be in that moment, there's a better way, there's a different way. And that's what I want to share with you. Call it Lifescale. I hope it's a movement. I hope it's something that's going to help you, but that's what it was created for. It was meant to shine the light on the things that we haven't really taken a look at. It's meant to cast a light in the darkness that's within that we haven't yet embraced. It's a light to cast outward to show us a path towards what happiness and possibility and success could look like, things that we didn't see or even realize before. It's a light that you can cast underneath you to show everyone where you're standing and every step that you take. That Lifescale journey isn't going to just teach us about what's happening or show us paths to productivity or even being focused or less distracted. It's actually a path that's going to make us everything that we imagined we could be and more. But more so, it's going to let other people around us see what they're not seeing today as well. Because this is a journey we all need to take together. Because certainly our mentors or our parents or our teachers or our managers or bosses or executives haven't yet realized that this is the path that they need to be on. Tomorrow's leaders are born right now. Tomorrow's opportunities are created by what you see differently than everybody else and what you do differently than everybody else. That's the journey I want to be on with you.